next speaker is an international representative. Last night in Brighton, John McDonald said that if he should become Chancellor of the Exchequer Shadow Spokesperson, they would organise a European conference on how to challenge austerity. We would hope from People's Assembly and from Greece Solidarity Campaign that we would also extend that to how to deal with debt and to enable the dropping of the debt in those countries which have it round their necks. But it gives me great pleasure to introduce Rosa Pavanelli, who is from Public Services International, PSI, if you know it by the initials. Rosa is the General Secretary.
For let me address this very important debate. I'm very pleased to be here and having the possibility to celebrate the victory of Jeremy Corbyn as a new leader of the Labour Party. And we know how much we need leaders like that for the political party. I'm the General Secretary of the Global Union Federation. The Global Union Federation organizing trade unions of public services workers around the world, and we represent 20 million workers in public services around the world. And we have been witnessing in those years the attack and the violence that an ideological system has put on public service workers, on public service, on public spendings, and on workers in general. You are part of this debate that's at the attack that the trade union bill is trying to put on workers in the UK. And unfortunately, I have to tell you, this is a very violent attack. But just this morning, we had to present a complaint to the ILO because a similar law passed recently in Canada. And we have many countries that are trying to keep the same attack on workers and public services mainly. What does it mean? It means that there is an ideological attack. And when they say that we are ideological, defending the privileges of public service workers and the privileges of public services, universal access in general, they are showing that they are the ideologist. And we are on the other side, defending common people, our community, working people, and our families. We have been witnessing in this year the cut to public spending, and it was in 2013, with my organization, the network of communication of our organization, we were in Athens trying to witness and to testimony what is happening when you cut health services, as it happened in Greece, when you cut water, when you cut energy, but you have a strong experience in the UK as well about that. So it's time to say that enough is enough, that workers deserve, first of all, respect and dignity. Then they deserve decent jobs, decent wages, fair wages, and a permanent contract, not the zero contract or the flexibility that we have been seeing proliferating in the last months. UK and Cameron government is leading these right-wing governments that have as objective to curb the living conditions of millions of workers in the UK, but also around the world. And I think that defending the NHS, defending public services, defending public education is something that we need, because there's no alternative to public services for working people if we want to have a decent life. How can it be possible that we go back 100 years at the beginning of the past century in terms of accessing public services, in terms of living conditions, in terms of wages, and in terms of working conditions? That is unacceptable, and it is in breach of many international labor standards and labor law that we need to bring again on the table, claiming for our rights. It has been mentioned now that Europe is facing a crisis that is not only the economic crisis and the austerity. It's the crisis of a model of development, of a model of consumption that we need to change. But it's also facing a humanitarian crisis. I honestly think that this is the biggest shame for Europe. Because how can a continent, which is the richest in the world, being afraid by some thousand refugees and asylum seekers running away from wars, from dictatorships, from unacceptable living conditions? And how can Europe continue to deal with governments like Eritrea in bilateral economic agreement in order to give them resources to keep migrants in the desert, in concentration camp in the desert? I think this matters. To conclude, in my work, I have to deal every day with the financial institution, with the IMF, with the World Bank, with the Regional Development Bank, and the leitmotif is private is better than public. Private is bringing more efficiency and more possibility to grow to the economy. Well, that's still to be demonstrated. What we have seen is that private is not working. Corporates are dictating the agenda of governments, are dictating the political agenda of all the governments. And we need to stop corporates that pretend to avoid tax, that pretend to evade taxation, that pretend to continue to use tax havens. We have to stop corporate when they pretend to dictate also the labor agenda. And we have to ask the government to be independent from corporate. Otherwise, there will be no hope. We have seen so many, even left-wing governments, being submitted to the will of the corporate. It's time to say stop, and it's time to change. You have started changing. I hope that will continue. We have some important deadlines in the next weeks in Europe. Let's hope and let's work to support all the movement of workers and democratic people that want to change Europe, that want a democratic Europe, and they want a solidarity for all. Thank you very much.